Hello everyone, welcome to the Moodle Academy webinar on setting up a Moodle development environment. I'm Rajnil Dottaram, developer educator at Moodle Academy, and I'll be your host and hosting host today and introducing our speakers today. And I'm joined by my colleague Anna Krasa to support me during this webinar. Today we are very happy to have four developers from Moodle HQ presenting today. First up, we've got Ruslan Kabalin, a senior developer with the Workplace Solutions team. We've got June Pataleta, an integration lead in the Moodle Platform team. And we have Noel DeMartin, analyst developer with the Mobile Solutions team. And Adrian Grieve, product delivery lead. The overview for today's session. We are going to have a look at what you need to have, what you need to do Moodle development. So there are many ways to install Moodle development. Our HQ developers will share two ways to set up your Moodle development environment. Noel, who works with the mobile apps team, will talk about Moodle app development. And finally, we will get to hear what's in plan for the dev jam that is going to happen in about 2 weeks' time. And in the end, hopefully we'll have some time to take some questions. So that's the plan for today's session. Getting started with Moodle development. Now, there are many ways to set up your Moodle development environment. A lot of it depends on the operating system that you use and your personal preferences. But essentially, you know, for a Moodle development environment, you will need to have PHP installed because Moodle is a web-based application written in PHP. You need to have a web server, such as Apache, a relational database, for example, MySQL, and obviously you will need to have Moodle installed. And it's recommended to have Moodle debugging enabled in your development environment. And to write code, you will need an IDE, and it's recommended to have Git also install, you know, so that you can manage your code changes. Now, like I mentioned, there are many ways to set up your Moodle development environment. And now our HQ developers will share at least two ways to set up your environment. I will stop sharing my screen and hand over to Ruslan, who's going to present on Moodle Dev Compose.
Yeah, so I'm going to talk about a sort of alternative approach for setting up developing environment. It's using the tool called Moodle Dev Compose, if you switch to the next. Slide, please. Yeah. So initially, when Docker was around, and I was thinking maybe I'll just need to start using a little bit different approach to setting up rather than installing all the services like MySQL, Postgres, Apache Web directly on the system. Is there a way to basically use Docker to make it a little bit easier for me, and the sort of things that I wanted to achieve with that is to have a clean system on a host, so avoid direct installation of service packages. It should be close to traditional approach of installation, the one that I used to be when I installed all the services directly, and have a flexibility to select particular services that I want to run and keep things consistent as well. So I could redeploy it when I need without much effort. And among other things, we're keeping different instances of different versions of Moodle running at the same time. So I could switch, test different patches with different versions, and haven't shared database instance, so I wouldn't need to run several different database instances for each for each web container, and keep one for everything, and keep that solution operating system independent as well. Basically, the Docker was around, and I started looking at what I can if I can achieve that with the Docker, and I came up with a started to use a very simple approach using Docker Compose to deploy the set of solution that set of services that I wanted to run at the same time. So Docker Compose is basically a tool that allows you to describe in YAML file which particular services you want to run on your system at the same time and configure them a specific way. If you could click on that Moodle lump compose file, simple lump compose file, the URL, yeah. And scroll it down a little bit. So this is just basically a simple example how you can create a very, very simple lump dev environment. It would require just two containers, which is web and MariaDB in this case. You can use the standard Moodle image for the web one. And mount the location of your Moodle code inside container. And pretty much that's it. Just configure some environment within MariaDB. So you would know which database name and database credentials you would use. Can you switch back to slide? And then you could just run Docker Compose up in Compose file directory, open browser, and it will be available to you straight away without need to any local installation of the system. Every service would live in a individual container, and if you run Docker Compose down after that, it will just basically destroy all containers, but the data remain in place because we used volumes for that. If you switch to the next slide, please. And Moodle Dev Compose is basically evolution of that simple approach, which I put together as a separate repository published on GitHub. It has a comprehensive setup documentation explaining step by step what you need to do to start using it. Among kind of main advantages, it's using another container, which is called Nginx Proxy, which allows you to set up several versions of Moodle using different web containers with different versions of PHP, and use some environment variable to give each of those web frontend a different name. And the proxy will just redirect your browser to the right container when you access it. It contains Mailpeed as well, so you don't need to think how to test email, for example, if you want to, you know, if you want your Moodle to send emails and see what actually been sent. So that's very useful service. So you could just open the interface and see what emails are coming from Moodle. It's easy to extend. It's also explained in the documentation how to extend it with creating different Compose YAML files that will be linked together to the original ones, and several examples how to add SSL, add memcache, using it with SAML authentication. So if you just click maybe on that link and scroll down a little bit at the scroll down just to show what's there. So it's basically explaining you what you need to do to start using it, and it's very clean. Also, it's basically it's just a Compose file, so you use all the Docker toolkit. There are no additional scripts for that for controlling those things, and I think it's kind of for the developer who want to start using Docker for running services. This is kind of fairly simple and gentle approach into, you know, to use Docker and for as a basically make Moodle dev environment Docker based. I think that's it for me. Thank you.
The next tool that we will look at is Moodle Ubuntu. So I will hand over to June.
So hi, I'm June. I'm an integrator from the Moodle LMS team. And I'd like to share to you this setup script called Moodle Ubuntu. It helps you set up a Moodle development or testing environment in Ubuntu. If you're an Ubuntu user, it might be useful for you. So a bit of a background. Back in 2017, Moodle contracted the testers from an external company. So we had to provide a Linux VM for them to use for their testing. So I'm kind of the one maintaining that virtual machine. And then it was a bit difficult to maintain because I have to repackage the image whenever Moodle requirements change, or and also the VM has a relatively large file size. So last year, I started writing Moodle Ubuntu based on the provisioning script from Moodle Vagrant that I was developing too. If you're not familiar with Vagrant, Vagrant is like a command line tool that helps set up virtual machines in an easy way. So if you would be asking why not just maintain Moodle Vagrant, it's because at that time the tester's machine lacked the requirements to support Vagrant. They also lack the requirement to, their machines lack the requirement to use, to install Docker. So we're kind of stuck in the VM approach. So so that's the background for my script. So what can be done here is how do you set up an Ubuntu machine? It's basically like simple four steps in general. You just have to like make a fresh installation of Ubuntu. You clone the Moodle Ubuntu repository and then run setup.sh, and then it will do everything, set up everything for you. You may need to respond to some prompts during setup, but it should be pretty easy. And then after that, you can start testing and or developing in Moodle. So after setup, the machine will have an Apache web server. It will have different PHP versions. Currently, it has it will install PHP 7.3 to PHP 8.2. You will also have like different databases set up, like PostgreSQL, MySQL, SQL Server, Oracle via Docker. And it will also install Moodle Development Kit or MDK. If you are new to developing in Moodle, Moodle Development Kit would be a very useful tool for you to help you work on Moodle, especially when contributing patches to Moodle. It will also install other things like Behat related stuff to allow you to run Behat tests on the machine. So if you want for more information, you can just check out this repository. And before that, I'd like to demo a little bit of about this setup script. So let me just move. I have to move to another machine. So I basically have this Moodle Ubuntu setup already. So at this stage, I just finished installing cloning Moodle Ubuntu. I just finished setting up a plain version of Ubuntu, so I can start cloning it, cloning the repository. Should be pretty quick. Then just run setup .sh. Then enter student password. Oh, sorry. There you go. And then, yeah, it will just do its own thing. And then, of course, I won't finish this. And I will just stop it. Just kill the machine. So that's it. So it's just, and then after setup, let's just store this one to show you what a finished setup script looks like. Let me just power up the VM. Cool. So this is the state of the machine after you have set it up. Time now. So you will have you will see that here that on the finished, when the setup script finishes, you will have the web server setup. There's an initial Moodle instance installed here too. So, and it's a bit slow. The VM is slow. There. So, yeah. So, you already have a Moodle instance installed. So, you will also have MVK installed and Git. Yeah. So, I think it's enough to get you started developing in Moodle. So what's next for this script is, in the future, I'd like to break it down into smaller setup scripts and improve the auto configuration, for example, to allow it to automatically set up your name or email for your GitHub config or your GitHub username, which is needed by MDK config, and probably make it smarter. Like in case of an error, it will allow you to resume from the last successful installation step. So something like that. But yeah, hopefully. That's it from me, I think. So thank you for listening.
Thank you, John. Now it's time for Moodle app development with Noel.
Okay, so basically I want to talk about Moodle app development, how you would go about developing for the Moodle app. And there are two kinds of things you would want to do. The first is plugin development, when you have a Moodle plugin and you want to add functionality that works in the Moodle app. And something else you may want to do is app development. This is taking the Moodle app and modifying its core functionality. So these are the two things I will get into today. There are also some advanced topics you may want to look into, like testing and native functionality, but I think those are something that you can get into later. If you have the first steps, it should be fine. So for the first one, for plugin development, basically you have to have a local Moodle instance installed. You can use one of the methods that June or Ruslan mentioned or anything else. You just need a local Moodle instance. You also need a Chromium browser. And I say Chromium because we are using some APIs that are not available, for example, in Firefox. This is on something only for development. The real application using native devices doesn't have this issue. But for development, you will need to use a Chromium browser. And also, you will need to configure it to disable some security flags that are also necessary for development. And once you get all of this set up, you should be able to start developing your plugin. Some things to keep in mind is that you need to enable web services in your Moodle instance. And the way I suggest that you test that your environment is working properly is you can install this local greetings plugin, which is a plugin from Moodle Academy, and in particular the Mobile Act 3 branch, which has the mobile functionality. And once you do that, you can use this browser, the Chromium browser set up for development, to visit this URL with a hosted version of the app. So you don't even need to install the app yourself. To show you some example of how to do that, first of all, you need to activate the mobile services, as I mentioned here. And once you do that, you can open your browser. I, for example, call it unsafe Chromium to this one with the special flags for development so that I don't confuse it when I want to use my normal browser, right? So once you are here, then you can visit this URL and this will open an instance of the mobile app. And you can use it to connect to your site. So once this is opened, for example, my site is localhost 8000. And I will log in with a test account, which is the admin account. I am using Moodle Docker to host my local instance. And once the application, once you are inside the site in the app, you can visit this menu and you go to the greetings. And this is what the plugin is doing. So if you see this, everything should be working properly. Something else I want to mention is if you want to make some changes, for example, imagine you change this string. If you go to the app and you reload, at first you will see it doesn't change. This is because sometimes parts of the plugins are cached for performance. In this particular case, for example, you have to go to your Moodle site and you have to purge cache, all the cache. Once you do that and you reload, everything should work properly. So right now I will reload and it should have taken all the changes. See, open. Yeah, and you see now it has the changes. Something else to keep in mind, you saw that when I refreshed the first time, it wasn't working. This is because the application is thought for mobile devices, not for a browser. And when you reload from some URLs, sometimes it doesn't work as you would expect. So in case anything is not working properly, you just visit the root URL and use the application normally and everything should work. So that is something to keep in mind in case you see something misbehaving. And other than that, if the push caches trick doesn't work, depending what you are doing with plugins, sometimes you may also need to resynchronize the site. So you would go here and you click this. And this would also refresh the plugin and all of that. I think with these two, with the synchronization and the push cache, you should cover all the situations. So basically that's it for plugin development. The other use case I was mentioning was app development. So in the example I was showing you, we were using a hosted version of the Moodle app that we have prepared for development. But if you want to modify any code of the app itself, not something in the Moodle site, you have to run the app locally. And the only requirement that we have really is that you have Node.js and NPM installed. And in particular, we strongly recommend that you use something like NVM, Node Version Manager. This is because one of the most common source of problems for people having issues running the app locally is that they don't have the correct version of Node or NPM installed. And then when you compile the app, it doesn't work as expected. But if you're using NVM, then it should be fine and it should take the exact version we have been testing with. So you can clone this repository with the code of the app. If you have NVM, you can run NVM install to make sure you are using the proper versions. And then you just install the dependencies and run NPM start. And then that should get your local instance working. In my case, I already ran it because it can take maybe one minute or so to work. I didn't want to keep you waiting. And once you see this compiled successfully, then it means that it's already working. Then in your browser, it should already have done this automatically. But in case it doesn't, you can visit the URL and you should be able to see the application running locally. Yeah, you see that now it's working and this running in localhost. So that's it. Now any change you make to the source of the app, it should be reflected here. And basically that's it for local development. So some extra things I wanted to mention in case you look into that. For testing, I recommend installing VNC Viewer or something similar if you want to debug acceptance tests. This is very useful because Behat normally runs automatically and you don't see what is happening. But using something like this, you can actually see the screen of the app and you can even open the dev tools and see what's going on, right? For running unit tests, you just do npm test and it will run all the jest tests. And for running acceptance tests using Behat, I have put the command here, but it's actually the same you would do for any normal Behat tests that you already do in Moodle, right? In my case, since I am using Moodle Docker, I'm using the VNC viewer, as I mentioned. And this is a screenshot of what you should see when you open the VNC viewer. You will see how the application is launched and is automated by Behat. And in case you want to run the tests of the core app, you will need to run this command. And this generates a local Moodle plugin with all the Behat features inside of the plugin, so that they are executed when you are running the Behat tests. And that should be it for testing. For native functionality, you need to have the native SDKs installed. So depending if you are doing Android or iOS. And the commands are just npm run prod Android or npm run prod iOS. And this should open an emulator in your computer running the native device. And you should be able to test that the application works properly. So that's mostly it. Some things before I finish is that I suggest reading the docs because we have a lot of links and more details about everything I just mentioned. In particular, if something is not working, I suggest looking at the troubleshooting section in the documentation because we have the solution to many common issues that people find. And finally, when something is not working as you expect, it's important to understand if it's something on the Ionic side, on the native side, or some Moodle issue. Because when you are searching for help to improve to solve your error, if you are using the proper context, it's a lot more likely that you find the solution. Because for example, if it's something wrong with Ionic and you are searching Moodle and the name of the error, it's very likely that this misleads the search engine and you cannot find the help you seek.
We've got some other questions regarding the Moodle development environment on setting up your Moodle installation. So there was a question on what is MDK?
MDK is something that it's a pretty useful tool for Moodle developers that helps them work on fixing on developing in Moodle. For example, it helps you create different Moodle instances easily. And it can also help you work on issues on the tracker. So for example, you can, for example, type in MDK fix, then the issue number. Let me just type here. Then it will create, for example, I've typed MDK fix 1.2.3.4.5, and then it will help you create a branch on your Moodle instance that with for that particular issue. Maybe it's easier to demo. Let me just share my screen. So for example, I'm working on this issue. They provide unique titles. So imagine I don't have a patch for this yet. So let me go to my Moodle instance. So I will say MDK fix, what issue number is that? 79048. 79048. So it will create a branch on my local repository, which I can use to, and then when I'm done working on my a fix, and then, so for example, this one already has a fix. So I can just, doesn't have a fix. I can easily push this to GitHub or something using a command like mdk push. It's like a bunch of different helper scripts that helps Moodle developers fix issues that they're working on. Oops. I can also help me create new Moodle instances, like for example, MDK create -i name. So it, for example, it will help me create a Moodle instance. So like this, and then later on my this is done, so I should be able to okay, sorry. It's not working. You sure it's working? Classic demo effect. But yeah, it's pretty handy for developers working on Moodle.
Thank you, Jun. So if you have enjoyed this session, we'd love you to consider getting involved further and help us grow by contributing to the development of Moodle Academy. You can do this by visiting our Get Involved course, which you'll find on the front page of the Moodle Academy site. You can suggest new ideas for new courses and webinars, and you can vote on ideas that have been already suggested by others. And we're always on the lookout for community members to help us to help present webinars and co-create short online courses. And we'd love your help in making Moodle Academy more inclusive. So if you are able to, please jump into our Translate Moodle Academy course and get started with helping us translate our courses and our webinars in other languages. And of course, please help spread the word about Moodle Academy by telling your colleagues and about our courses and the events that we run. When you complete a course, you will earn a badge. And thank you very much for joining us today. I hope you found today's session useful. Thank you to our presenters. And we hope to see you on Moodle Academy course forums and in our upcoming webinars. We try to have a webinar every month, so please check out the Moodle Academy website. And if you have any further questions, you can write them on the discussion forum in the affiliated course for the Moodle community members to answer.